did not take taxes, so God will have mercy when he comes. This is loot and plunder. How this nation is so. I don't want to talk as philosophically about this thing, but the point is that if you do this man, they don't want to pay income tax. Abhi Sahib is suggesting to those measures, but they are only interested in photographic stations with the number of the ruling party and concessions and right off. How much tax are you paid by the textile sector, by the sugar sector, by the food? I know a letter has been written by this government that members of the parliament are opposing imposing of taxes on power people. Then you want common men to be imposed on the families out of poverty. 7 million means 4 per person means 28 million. This is the way of zakat and microfinance. And this should be done on a small scale. 5-10 people joining hands, collecting some sort of zakat, making arrangements with microfinance or the so-called Islamic bank. If at all they are Islamic, none of them is Islamic in Pakistan. In any case, nobody has examined their working. But for this purpose, except the interest-based banks and these banks, and there should be linkage with zakat and microfinance. The one thing, how to get rid of the IMF? Because their sole intention is to destroy the economy and pressurize the North Pakistan, which is the security for the army. The only way is that there should be a law in the country. And that law, if you remember, from 1947 to 1992, there was a law in Pakistan. As nobody can maintain a foreign currency account abroad in excess of 1,000. Now, at least can we frame a law that all the members of the parliament and civil and military bureaucracy starting, they must be directed that they should bring their accounts from abroad to Pakistan. And if they do so, only say about $50 billion or $100 million out of, I don't know what, then you offer 4% or 4.5% to overseas Pakistan. That if they open an account here or abroad for 1 year and more, and if you can get, they have got liquid assets of about $150 billion. And Pakistanis living in Pakistan have assets of about liquid assets of $75 billion. I'm talking of only overseas Pakistanis. If they can, out of $150 billion, their interest rate is 1%, yeah, and for them 4%. And they feel since the president, the prime minister, parliamentarians have their accounts here, then they will not be frozen again, as Nawaz Sharif did under the sanctions of IMF and said it was a mistake. It was a direct. So this way you can get rid of the IMF if this law is framed and the government pressurizes. And one suggestion which is Nawaz has explained that 46% of the world trade of the engineering goods and 6% of the textile. And whole our pressures of the textiles competing from 6% commercial we get. But we are not doing anything about this 46%. My last point is that we should pick up some selected cases for taking action, and they should be followed. One was the sugar crisis. The second thing is that of this mysterious role of Friends of Pakistan. And I can tell you one thing on record. I can give you in writing commitment here that Friends of Pakistan never ever committed to a penny to fund. They have been telling lies. All budgets were fraud. And I have got a confirmation. I have been saying in budget, 2010 budget was a fraud in the sense that Friends of Pakistan never committed. And we included this. I got a statement from American government that we are not going to give anything to Pakistan cash on the table. What we can do is certain investments on projects. But that investment are not a part of the budget. So why this crisis? Because we have been making false budgets. And when Shaukat Tareen was talking plan A, plan B and C, I was saying that there is no plan except to take loans, that was false. And to go to IMF, this government arranged depreciation of rupee in August 2008 intentionally. And at that time, IMF said that if Pakistan wants, they can delay it by 1 year. Taking loans from IMF, the government was keen, this was a fraud. So can we make it a standpoint? There were those plans A, B and C. Has government any commitment from the Friends of Pakistan that they will give a penny, or it was a fraud for 2 years? And how this budget was framed? The figure is this, that in 2009 budget, the total allocation for external receipt was 333 billion rupees. We got only 189 billion from various things. This includes reimbursement of this coalition support fund, but not a penny, and they will not be giving it. They will give you something for earthquake or this floods, but nothing cash on the table. So these are the things. Our thing is that we'll cover taxes, reduce corruption, tax division, have a uniform policy, and unless we are able to form a pressure group, I think government, for this 10-point agenda of the fraud, Nawaz Sharif did it so that this government doesn't fall. And I said, if that very day, the proof is that one of his demands was that all appointments should be on merit. And when the governor was appointed in Punjab, who was dismissed twice, and he has committed fraud in the court and apologized. He was appointed governor, and Nawaz Sharif was the first man to come with this. So this 10-point rule will not be there, only cosmetic changes. So nation has to decide that this with tremendous potentiality, we are the worst performing nation now. And our education expenses are lower than Africa. So I think the professional bodies have a role, what banks are doing, what Islamic banking is doing, what is the taxation policy, why RBST, why this exorbitant expenditure. And this is our country, so don't do it, I think it will be very good. Thank you very much.